Hi everyone, this is Veronica. Today we are going to talk about an online tool by WHO, that is AWARE. So the tagline here is handle antibiotics with care. So here they want to give the guidelines to the public, international public, that antibiotics should be used very carefully. So what are the reasons behind that? We'll discuss that. And what is this tool? This is a channel, StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, a pen drive and tablet courses are also available. For additional information, you can call us on our numbers or you can visit our website too. And if you're preparing for UPSC CSE 2020, then we have a pen drive course. Here you can find 100% coverage of UPSC vast syllabus, daily current affairs updates, self-paced learning. It has been prepared by top faculties of India and at the rate of 625 per month only. So what is the relevance of this topic in your exam? In your mains paper 2, health and education, it will be covered under this. Objective level, you should know about this tool by WHO. And at subjective level, you should understand what is antimicrobial resistance. So to connect with me, you can follow me on Instagram and Facebook even for your queries. So now let's start this topic. The WHO has launched a global campaign for the international people, international public. Now, before going forward, we'll discuss a little bit about WHO. The World Health Organization, it is a specialized agency of United Nations, and that it is concerned with international public health. That is what it does. It is headquartered in Geneva. Geneva is in Switzerland. And WHO's constitution, it came into force on April 7, 1948. Now this date is celebrated every year as World Health Day. So the World Health Assembly. So in WHO, there is a World Health Assembly, which is a supreme decision-making body. And this assembly meets annually and is attended by delegations from 194 member states. And recently you have seen a high level summit even in the Delhi. Ministers and delegation, they adopted digital health for sustainable development, and it was adopted at the concluding session of 4th Global Digital Health Partnership Summit. So now about AWARE, that is our today's topic. The World Health Organization in its global campaign against antibiotics. So this campaign is against the antibiotics, and it has launched a new online tool. Right. So this campaign aims to achieve 60% increase in the use of antibiotics under the access group cheap narrow spectrum drugs. See, I'm using the word here, narrow spectrum, that WHO wants us to use to increase the use of antibiotics to 60%, but in narrow spectrum. There's other term known as broad spectrum. Now to understand what are the narrow spectrum medicines and what are the broad spectrum medicines and why they are promoting narrow spectrum antibiotics. So just to make it easy for you, let me tell you, suppose this is human body and it is attacked by some microorganisms, let it be bacteria. Those bacteria are round in shape, right? So now what does this narrow spectrum medicines do? They will specifically attack the round bacteria. As you know, we have a lot of microorganisms in our body which are beneficial to our body also. They are star, they could be star shaped, they could be square shaped, they could be triangle. So this narrow spectrum medicine will attack only the specific bacteria that you want to kill. But if we take the broad spectrum medicine, then what happens? It kills all kind of bacteria. It can kill round bacteria, triangle, square, everyone. And then if we keep on taking the broad spectrum bacteria, it will kill the useful microorganisms also. Plus, it could lead to antimicrobial resistance, because as you know, our body evolves, as our body evolves, that is very slow evolution change. But these microorganisms, they evolve at a very greater pace, at a very greater speed. That I'll tell you when we'll talk about antimicrobial resistance. But for now, you should know what are narrow spectrum medicines and what are broad spectrum medicines. So narrow, to say it in one word, you can say they target specific microorganisms rather than several, and also lower the risk of resistance. So now to talk about this tool AWARE, it has classified the antibiotics into three groups. So this AWARE tool, it was developed by WHO essential medicines list. So their aim is to contain rising resistance and make antibiotic use safer and more effectively by providing guidelines over the effective use of antibiotics to the policymakers and the health workers. So these three groups, first is your excess. So in excess, antibiotics, which antibiotics fall under this group, this category? Antibiotics used to treat the most common and serious infections. Then there is watch group. Antibiotics available at all times in the healthcare system will fall under this group, all antibiotics which are regularly available. And in reserve category, there will be antibiotics to be used sparingly, that will be used very rarely or preserved and used only as a last resort. Because you might have seen at your homes also what we do, if we fall sick, we even don't go to the doctor, we just go to the chemist and take a antibiotic which may be very strong, that means which may be from the reserved category. So if we do not get fine with that medicine, then we don't have any other medicine to take because we have already taken the strongest medicine. So that is why what doctors do, they give you very light medicine so that if it does not, you do not become well, they can switch to this category, then to this category. But what we do, we take the strongest medicine at first. So now what is the significance of this? See, by classifying the antibiotics into three distinct groups and advising on when to use them, AWARE makes it easier for policymakers, prescribers, that means doctors and the health workers, to select right antibiotic at the right time. This will protect the endangered antibiotics also, and it will protect the antimicrobial resistance also. See, this resistance is not built up by the humans, but this resistance is by the microorganisms. That means these medicines have no effect on microorganisms if they build up this resistance. So this is the significance, we can prevent this. Now talking about antimicrobial resistance, now see, with the emergence of infections that are untreatable by all classes of antibiotics, antimicrobial resistance is really turning into an invisible pandemic, and it is estimated to kill 50 million worldwide people and 10 million only in India by 2050. So according to a report by the International Coordination Group on Antimicrobial Resistance, antimicrobial resistance is a global health and development threat that continues to escalate globally, and it threatens to undo a century of medical progress because it can kill people, whole community. So it is estimated that more than 50% of antibiotics in many countries which are used inappropriately, such as for the treatment of viruses when they only treat bacterial infections. So if somebody has a viral infection, why we will take this bacterial antibiotic? That is, we are inappropriately taking it. Or use of wrong, that means the broader spectrum, as I told you the difference between. So there, some people, what they use broader spectrum antibiotics. Thus this contributes to the spread of antimicrobial resistance, because what happens in broad spectrum, as I told you, there will be many bacteria in your body, but suppose the infection is caused by this bacteria, but now you are making other bacterias face this antibiotic, strong antibiotic also, then they will evolve, they will change, they will understand, okay, now every time you're targeting me with these kind of medicines, I will evolve a resistant. So they start fighting back, and then they are evolved enough that this antibiotic does not show any effect on other microorganisms also. So when in communicable diseases, these kind of microorganisms, they cause infections in other humans and to other humans and to whole community, then the antibiotics we have, they will not show any effect on the population. So this can prove very dangerous in the near future. So then what happened? These kind of bacteria may infect humans and animals also, and the infections they cause are harder to treat than those caused by non-resistant bacteria. See, antibiotic resistance occurs naturally also. It does not mean it is only caused by the medicines, but it occurs naturally at a slower rate. But misuse of antibiotics in humans and animals is accelerating the process. The growing number of infections such as pneumonia, tuberculosis, salmonellosis are becoming harder to treat as antibiotics used to treat them become less effective. So see, what are the concerns here? So one of the most pressing concern is the spread of resistant gram-negative bacteria. So first of all, what is this gram-negative bacteria? They are more dangerous. Their two bacteria are classified into two groups. One is your gram-negative bacteria, another is your gram-positive bacteria. So it depends on the whether they retain a specific stain. For gram-positive bacteria, it retained a purple color stained if you stain it in the laboratory, and for the negative, it appears red or pink. Now, several species of gram negative bacteria, you might have heard about E. coli, Escherichia coli, they are common causes of foodborne diseases. Then there is Vibrio cholera. It causes cholera, which is a waterborne pathogen. Now, gram-negative bacteria can also cause respiratory infections also. Certain types of pneumonia, sexually transmitted diseases, including your gonorrhea, right? So, infections like this, pneumonia, bloodstream infections, they could be caused. As these bacteria, which are commonly seen in the hospitalized patients, they cause these kind of infections. Although over 100 countries have put in place national plans to tackle antimicrobial resistance, only about 1/5 of such plans are funded and implemented. So antibiotic resistance, so what will be the result in the end? Antibiotic resistance, when antibiotics stop working effectively, increases health expenditure and makes accessibility and affordability of medicines expensive affair. Right? So this is the, these are the concerns, and this is the result, that the treatment will become non-affordable. It will lead to higher medical cost, prolonged hospital stays, and increased mortality also. So now, what is required? What should be done? See, in the absence of development of new drugs, so suppose there is some infection for which the community has developed, not the community, but the organism, microorganism, pathogens have developed antimicrobial resistance. So we must safeguard these precious line of antibiotics. Usually what happens when any infection breaks out, then only we start following it. But prevention is always better than cure. So we should prevent. So you also, who all are watching this video, you should tell your parents, you should tell the people around you, you should not take antibiotics before the doctors prescribes it. If you fall sick, you should go to a doctor and then let him prescribe a light dose of antibiotic for you. This is the best kind of prevention that we can do for now, to ensure that we can still treat and prevent serious infections, right? So this is what you need to understand and aware the people about the antimicrobial resistance. That is what is the use of this aware tool. In this tool, online tool, you'll find different categories. As I told you, access watch and the reserve category of medicines. So this is all about today's lecture. If you have any queries, you can contact me on Instagram and Facebook. Thank you.